Welcome back, everybody. We're doing a little series on what happens when we die in response to all these questions that some of our people on social media have been curious about. It began with Jenny. Thanks, Jenny, for emailing them in, and then others have added. I think even though Jenny asked many questions, we have covered them all in the previous three videos we've already filmed. And so we have another question from Giedre. And she says, look, my question is about the frustration of old age, dementia, Alzheimer's disease, the effects of a stroke and even coma. Why do sometimes we have to wait, people who are in that state have to wait 10 years to die? And this is interesting. She's talking more about nursing homes and everything like that. The dementia, Alzheimer's reality, we know has a lot to do now with lifestyle. They've been doing experimentation on even vitamin B12 that can help a lot, and a proper diet can help a lot with exercise, with positive thinking, with just lifestyle. Can stop a lot of the dementia and Alzheimer's that people are going into right now. So we need to look at good holistic preventative medicine education programs. But like you, Gert, I've seen many people's friends, many of my friends, their family, their parents have gone into this and lived a long time, confined to beds, their physical body strong, but they've needed this long-term care while their body, the physical body's health, has deteriorated in line with the deterioration of their mental and then often emotional health. And it is hard on relatives. I would love to see that this changes, that we do adopt a very holistic lifestyle, like we live for source feeding, and like we live, as we talk about in our Alchemy of Health and Healing online course, as preventative medicine. So we can stay strong, healthy, mentally and emotionally and physically for as long as we want to be here. But we don't have that educational paradigm yet in the West. It's not shared widely yet. So on a soul level, this is how a soul has just chosen to exit at the time. They say that it's almost like a slow checkout, that when people are in the dementia, Alzheimer's, they're like in this zone, but they've already begun to move into another zone. And what's interesting is the timeline they often choose. I know when my father was exiting his life, this life, he was anchored in the war period. There was a lot of things he needed to resolve from being through the Second World War that he needed to look at vibrationally and deal with vibrationally so that that could dissolve and he could move into the next zone when he crossed over with the final letting go of his form. So I'm told on another level that when people are choosing the dementia or the Alzheimer's, or that is happening for whatever reason. Let's say it was an exit pre-planned before they even took embodiment this life, or somewhere along the line that it was giving them time to unpack energetically from this reality to the next. So I think what's required for all of us in our world right now is unconditional love. Really? No matter what our family and friends are choosing in their journey as a vast multidimensional consciousness, one drop of them, of their pure essence consciousness like ours, is in this body here now. Can we trust that their soul is controlling their journey on earth, their entry time, their exit time, and the way they are exiting? And if they've chosen this way for whatever reason, maybe lack of awareness on dietary levels or anything, the lifestyle they live that has put them into this position now, or the human wounds. You know, we have so many diseases in our world that are strongly connected now with lifestyle. And lifestyle is completely connected with our human wounds. I see this. I am dealing with a lot of people with mental health issues right now and with anorexia and other things. And all of it is wounds that they've received through their journey of life as children, as teenagers and more. And the way that they've unpacked that and the way the neural pathways have been formed that has then influenced their choice lifestyle and then their patterns of health. I feel my voice is a bit like, I feel their sorrow. I feel your sorrow. I feel the sorrow of family who are watching people suffer and asking why. If there's a God, why is there suffering in this world? But we are these divine beings. We are choosing, our soul is choosing our experience in this world for many, 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 many reasons. How can we support each other? We support each other with the purest flow of unconditional love, to just love, love, love. The I love you meditation we've given you freely, to be able to say to yourself, I, the divine I, in this form, I love you, 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 to embrace yourself in divine arms, your divine arms as a pure being, and heal your human wounds with this, I love you, I love you, I love you. Imagine you're a child with your wounds and you're sitting on the lap of a divine being of the greatest capacity of love and nurturing light. And just absorb that. Hold everyone you love in your meditation space, no matter where they are, no matter what they're going through, in the arms of love. We've already done a meditation called the embrace, embrace and hug. And you can do this. You can just imagine, as I do every day, that this divine beingness is moving through me. And I am embracing as a vast multidimensional consciousness the whole world and every suffering human being and every sentient life upon the world. And just to every day in this embrace, say, I love you, I love you, I love you, I love you. As the divinity I am, I love you, I love you, I love you. Take this love and do what you need with this love. If you need it for healing, there is an infinite source of love embracing you. Feel it. Open to it. Do that with everyone you know who's struggling, individually, collectively. Do it to the world. This is one of the greatest gifts we can give our world and each other right now. You know, there's a story a woman told me. She was Buddhist. Her father was dying and he hadn't taken on board all the Buddhist principles. She wanted him to have the perfect death. She wanted to take him through the bardo, the different levels of ways of exiting the body. She banned all the relatives from the room, all the loved ones who'd come to say goodbye to him. She said they had to go so she could take him through the perfect journey, even though he chose not to be a Buddhist. She created so much damage to that family. And she realized that after, people disconnected and wouldn't spend time with her anymore because she was inflicting her reality on her father as he was dying and inflicting her reality on all the family and friends, instead of just saying, all are welcome to express their love for this man as he transitions in the perfect way he needs to transition now. And I will not be in judgment and I will not be in control. Instead, I will be here as a silent, loving presence. And imagine I'm just holding my father who I love so dearly in my arms as he crosses over, not even being there to physically touch him even perhaps, because some of you can't be with loved ones now who are crossing over. But can you just imagine holding them and just saying what needs to be said from your heart, listening to what they need to say, and just, I love you, I love you, I love you, I love you, take this love and journey, exit in the right way and time for you. I love you, I love you, I love you, I love you, I love you. Can you go into those dementia wards energetically every day and hold the loved one who no longer recognizes you? Maybe doesn't remember you, or maybe has fleeting glimpses of who you are. And can you just embrace them energetically and just love them unconditionally? I love you, I love you, I love you. I accept the journey your soul has chosen this life. Take this love I offer freely. I love you, I love you, I love you. Do with it whatever your soul needs. Stay on earth, go on earth, whatever is your perfect journey. I love you, 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 I love you. Let's go on.